praise God, everyone who's here to listen. Posted on my channel, we've aired. I never uploaded for a long time, but now, let's not get into the details. I know I was busy in that, and then you have to find a quiet moment like this. But thankfully to God, we have a day today, and I prayed before, and I wanted this to be blessed. I wanted to send a message that I found. We're going to be reading from one place. I'm going to say a short message and end it. But that short message, I hope it gives you a little boost or a little, you know, spike, or so you'll be fired for God. So you will go for God and have Him the center of the peace. Sorry if I stumble or anything, because I usually preach in Russian, like in my church, whatever, but for you too, most are Americans, and preaching in English will, I guess, be the case. So Luke chapter 14, verse 16. Jesus replied, "A certain man was preparing a great banquet and invited many guests. At the time of the banquet, he sent his servant to tell those who had been invited, 'Come, for everything is now ready.' But they all alike began to make excuses. The first said, 'I have just bought a field, and I must go and see it. Please excuse me.' Another said, 'I have just bought 5 yoke of oxen, and I'm on my way to try them out. Please excuse me.' Still another said, 'I just got married, so I can't come.' The servant came back and reported this to his master. Then the owner of his house became angry and ordered his servant, 'Go out quickly into the streets and alleys of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame.' 'Sir,' the servant said, 'what you ordered has been done, but there is still room.' Then the master told the servant, 'Go out to the roads and country lanes and compel them to come in, so that my house will be full. I tell you, not one of those who were invited will get a taste of my banquet.'" And then after, it just talks about large crowds are traveling Jesus. So first, before I get into details, I'm gonna read. So when Jesus, you can see the master or whatever, said, "Go get the people that were supposed to come," the first said, but they all like began to make, so the first said, "I have just bought a field and I must go and see it. Please excuse me." Right away, when I was reading this yesterday or today, something touched my heart. That these are excuses that are not even real. I'm not gonna buy a car that I don't know, that I've never seen. I'm not gonna buy a field, I'm not gonna buy an animal. If you guys think about it, if someone said, "Oh, buy this house," and I said, "Okay, I'll buy it and I'll just pay," and then someone says, "Go to a party," and I say, "I have to see the house." Who buys a house or anything before seeing it? Here it says, but they all began to make excuses. The first one said, "I have just bought a field." So he bought it. So in my imagination, as in America, we would buy a land, we would see, discover it, it's affordable, it's good, water, whatever, okay, buy it. But the next part is, "And I must go and see it." So right away, this makes nonsense. Nobody buys anything without not knowing it. I'm not gonna buy this or that or a camera or anything. Like, I don't say, "Oh yeah, this guy could be my friend," by not knowing him, not talking to him, because what if he's not Christian at all? What if he's an atheist? What if he's trying to bring me down instead? "Oh yeah, whatever." You know, you gotta make a relationship first. You don't just get married to someone. Up, okay. But here, the interesting part is, I bought a field. I have to go see it. Sorry for like pausing a lot, but I'm confused. I'm not saying that Jesus said this wrong. Jesus didn't make sense. It's the people that, it's us that make excuses that don't make sense. After reading this place, I always read it and I said, and I thought to myself, okay, yeah, they made excuses, whatever, I guess. They should have done this earlier, like bought the land before everybody. They said, alike began to make excuses. It's like they all talked and said, okay, let's make all excuses. But after reading it this one time, something touched me in the heart. It wasn't even realistic. You can't buy land without seeing it. So let's now move on. Another said, "I have just bought 5 yoke of oxen and I'm on my way to try them out. Please excuse them." And I've heard this before, like we were talking with our teacher, our teacher was talking about that you don't buy, pretend, a cow or a calf, not trying it out, and then after all, gotta try it. You don't buy something. For example, if I bought cows or something, and or a dog, and it keeps on barking and doesn't, like you could say, be quiet, then I would have not bought it. See, You can't buy something without seeing it. I'll read it again. I have bought 5 yoke of oxen, and I'm on my way to try them out, to see how they act, how they behave. When you bought them, didn't you already try them? So these excuses, and again, the last part, please excuse me. The one before that, please excuse me. So they're making up excuses in our life. We need to stop making excuses. I don't know, I'm still thinking what my sermon is probably gonna be. Stop making excuses for stuff. Physical, spiritual. For example, go clean your room. Oh, mom, I need homework. Go do the chores. Oh, mom, this and that and this and that. And that. Go do it. There's nothing to stop unless if it's like physical. If you're a physical whore, that makes sense or whatever. But when God calls you and then you make excuses, oh, God, I have this, I have this, I have school, I have sports. I can't do that. Someone else could do that. He will. He'll find someone else. But what fruit are we gonna bring? Still another said, I just got married so I can't come. This one is pretty interesting. Because after this, the third one, the last one, I know it's a parable, but the last one, he didn't say, please excuse me. He just said, I just got married, I can't come. Another question, does marriage really separate us from God? Does it put a borderline? This is ours, and that's God. This is our time to spare, that's God's time. I know this might be a long sermon, but you know what I thought? If you say your word, if it's an hour or two, but if it's a touching, why do we make so many excuses? I just got married. I just got a car, I gotta try it out, But God's calling you. He said it's time to go. It's time to go. Nope, I got married. Does marriage really separate us from God? Yeah. For example, I get married to a Christian lady. We both serve God, but she's a sorry. We got married, we can't come. It physically maybe yes. If I got married pretend on Saturday and Sunday there's but. So let's move on. Servant came back and reported this to the master. Then the owner of the house became angry and ordered his servants. He became angry. Why? Because they're making excuses that weren't reliable. He didn't do something beyond their abilities. He didn't say, go pick up 10,000 pounds right now. And then he would get angry for nothing. Or if I said, go move this car with your bare hands. And then I would get angry. Doing something that's impossible. He said, just come. I'm calling you. They made excuses. And he said he got angry. And he called other people. He said, go out quickly to the streets and alleys of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, and blind, and the lame. Let's take it from a different perspective. Now it's not excuses. We're going to touch that a bit after, probably. Now it's, okay, Jesus called me. I'm serving God. I'm trying my best to be clean, be holy, because it says, be holy for I am holy. We're trying to do commandments, love your neighbors like yourself, do that, love God with all your heart, with all your mind. And we're doing all this, but one problem. We're not missionaries. I'm not saying we have to go somewhere. I'm in school, work, everywhere. Unless if you're stuck home and even there on social media or anywhere, you could preach the gospel. I'm doing this right now because I find this where the Holy Spirit could talk through me, through whoever's standing here or in church and say his word. And so when God calls us, and we don't do anything for him, what's the point of coming to God? That's the message that I wanted. In the beginning I said that I wanted, and this is one of the main importance. Don't come to God if you're not going to do anything for him. For example, I'm best friends with someone, and I'm like, oh yeah, we'll be best friends, but I never bought him anything, I never did really anything, we're just friends. Pretend he does everything for me. He bought me some new shoes, he bought me coffee, whatever. We have good relationships, but I don't do anything for him. It's like for Jesus. Jesus died. He shed his blood. He did everything for you. And now, he's waiting for us, for our turn, for us to return. I'm not saying we have to go kill ourselves or go die or we have to die on the cross like Jesus did. Jesus separated us. He said, I came not for peace but for separation. For what? To separate you from your mother. To separate you. from the world. I'm not saying we can't talk to our mothers. I'm talking about separation from sin, separation from all of this, because he said, my kingdom is not from here. My kingdom is from there, from heaven. And if you agree with me, say amen. And then the masters go out on the roads and country lanes and compel them to come in so that my house will be full. I tell you, not one of those who were invited will get a taste of my banquet. Imagine we hear this word. We're serving God, but when it comes, we're out. We didn't do anything for God. God called us, but we, you know. And so today's message is, again, to look over our lives. What have we been doing to God? Have we been making excuses when, for example, God says, go do that, do this, and we say, God, I can't. God, I don't have the ability. Remember Moses? When the burning bush and God said, go tell. He said, I can't speak. He said, go. He said, send someone else. But still, God did his work through Moses. So praise God for that. That God could find another person. But he will still use you. So let God help us not to make excuses. So we check ourselves. So we read the Bible and like this. Don't make excuses. When God puts in your heart to go missionary, and you said, I don't have the finance. I don't have that. My uncle, he was talking about, had no finance. He did it. And he had a thing, desire to go to a missionary, and what happened was this guy came and said, oh, I wanted to talk, and he gave him money. So he could pay the missionary. So God, if God puts on your heart, for example, to go downtown Portland, to the other side of America, to Africa, to India, to Ukraine, to all these countries and continents, like Jesus said, go around everywhere and preach the gospel, and whoever calls into my name will be saved, then God will solve everything. If it takes finance, he will give you a person, or he'll solve the problem. There's no excuses. God wouldn't be like, okay, go missionary, but it's impossible. So I did my sermon. I wanted to say, let's not make excuses. Let's stop making excuses. I'm kind of guilty of this saying this, but we need to stop making excuses, because excuses don't get you anywhere. Excuses only will hold you back. I know there's, from the world's perspective, like TED Talk and everything and excuses, but I'm talking about like the spiritual way. When God tells you to do something, when instead of serving for God in church and missionaries and that, we make excuses. Oh, I can't do that. I have no time. I have work. I can't go to church. I have no time for church. Then quit the job. Why are we living here? What's the point of going to church? Are we really just going to church and wasting our time if we're not going to end up in heaven? Why not just sit and do nothing and do what our flesh wants, not our spirit? But God called us for a reason. He has something for us more than we expect, more than we imagine. A heaven with golden streets and all of this. So I'm going to wrap it up pretty fast, because some of you guys might be watching this and time is going by. This is probably my longest sermon, but I feel the Holy Spirit is talking. Do not make excuses. See you guys next time. And please, thank you.